Hi. I went through the internet to search marathon data for world record, marathon data for the year 1988 all the way to 2018. Now, we have about how many Kenyans? So we can see Kenyans have been breaking the marathons straight from 2011 to 2018. And Eliud Kipchoge is attempting through with the Ineos challenge to break into sub 2. Now, I charted this data, but I realized inserting time data, we have, that is the year data, and the time data, that is the number of minutes and seconds and microseconds that these runners achieved during the previous marathons was quite a task. So we're going to start to prepare. We start by preparing our data so that we make sure that Excel recognizes that this is the years, and we have it on the secondary axis. We have the time the runner took to run. So I'm going to delete this and start from scratch. First, you realize that as much as you enter the data, if you have time data, for example, 2019 to 1988, usually Excel, if you have the year like that, and you enter 1988, 1999, 2000, 2001, 2002, 2006, 2010, and 2010 here. Say you have your data there. This is a data. So I'm going to enter random numbers like that and try to insert a chart and see what Excel is going to chart. So insert it, then we insert a line chart like that. If you do that, we realize that Excel does not recognize this as years. So in terms of preparing your data, it's important that you format your data sets as time. For example, for 2019-2018, you realize that I've entered one stroke 2018. So initially, if it was a date, you could get it in this format like that. But if for us to chart, because we want the years, we need to format our data set. Right click, then go to format cells. From format cells, we're going to go to custom and use the custom format here so that it is only 1-4 Ys like that. Then you click OK to get the years like that. If I chart this, this is a time taken for the race. If I insert a chart like that, you insert it, then I insert a line chart. We realize that Excel, as much as it gives us the chart, this is not representative because we want the years to come to the x-axis and the time on the y-axis. So what we're going to do is do some trick, add a column here, and let Excel do that like that. Then we're going to put numbers, normal numbers. Don't worry, even it shows 1900, but these are digits we are going to format as numbers. So I come there, I format as a number like that. Then I'm going to insert my chart now. So insert the line chart. So I'm going to go to insert, then I insert it and select one here. So you realize now Excel has picked my ears on the x-axis. Next is to bring the time. So I'm going to copy this and replace with the time here like that. Then I'm going to delete this. Then from there I need to format my time. So once you're done, you see now it shows us that in 1988 we had 2 minutes 6 seconds and 50 microseconds or milliseconds, and in 2019 Eliud Kipchoge is trying to break sub 2, that is 1.5 5959. Then you can do the others, might be we can put assign the elements, which is chart chart axis on the primary vertical. I'm going to put that as time. go back here, then check axis and say primary vertical is actually the time. Is it primary vertical is the time, and these are years here, and you get a beautiful chart like that. So thanks for watching. Remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel.